That's seventh hole, 452 yards. Carl's got another good one away. He's probably got around a 9-iron, maybe 8-iron in hand. He should really be drawing this into the flag because the wind's coming off his left. What's his reaction tell us? He's leaning back a bit. I don't think he's playing for birdie. So Karl has indeed missed another green with just a short iron in hand. It's twice so far this round. He's just had 130 odd yards and missed the green. Put himself under enormous pressure here to save par because he's... Well, him and Brett have both short-sighted themselves. They've got only about 3 steps of green to work with where the flag is. Now, Karl looks like... What's he gonna do here? Karl looks like he's just going to try and pitch it onto the very edge of the collar. And get the collar to kill it. But he's gotta have to do a lot of work with his short irons because they're the worst I've seen since Karl was 7 years old. Which tells me that he hasn't been putting the time in on the short irons. Because there's this amazing coincidence you get with reward for putting time in to that part of your game, and now he's left himself with 15 feet for par. So Karl has saved par from 15 feet. Club short there. It was online, but a club short. Let's pick the ball up here for you. There we go. I'm not sure why Karl takes the flag out, because the flag can actually help him in the situation. The hole is just near that ball that's sitting there on the green. Just a straightforward bump and run. Doesn't get any more straightforward. Should be aiming to hold this 1 in 10 times. Wedge. 172 yards, par 4. This Karl's tee is adjacent to another tee box. Wheels straight into his face at about 10 miles an hour. Just starting to come up a bit. Seems very happy with it. Great solid sound. Right after splitting the middle of the fairway. Into the wind. What did I say, short? Probably, he's still probably got 150 yards. So it's going to be around a 9-iron, maybe 8-iron. Tournament, even after this round, actually. So Karl's left himself with a good 45, 50 feet here. He's only a yard off the green, so he's going to employ his putter. To get the ball up to the hole. He's been short of the hole. Very good putt. That's a par, 2 over through the 9. Have no idea where that puts him. Probably 110, 120 to the hole. get this way. There we go, that's more like it. That's a lot more like it. That's his first genuine birdie putt there. Can't come about 12 feet. A draw. Interesting. Karl's on a spot above here. He's missed the fairway right. First missed fairway of the round. And he's in the lead and he's done. He's only 50 yards out, but he's got the bunker in the way, so he can't go straight on the hole. He's going to have to just strike it on the front left side of the green. Okay, should be able to get it up and down from there. So it's just plus the advantage of this short hole there. Right, so Karl's going to be chipping this up. They need about 8 feet short, 11 feet out to the hole. That club face at impact when he needed to be leaving that club face square. When you close that club face, you get less loft, the ball will run out further, which is what it's done. So his par's not assured yet because he's 6 feet past the hole. Even touch the hole with his first putt. But it was the first fairway that Karl's missed, and he chose the wrong fairway to miss because he stymied himself. Couldn't get anywhere near the green with his second shot, even though he was only 50 yards out. Speaking of how, I'm about 90 to 100 yards out to the tee box here. A hybrid or a 3-wood. So Karl's 3-wood is in the perfect position on the fairway, just short of the creek. It's left with around 110 yards to the green. Or to the hole, I should say. Leaning back with his wedges. Yeah, he's just leaning back with his wedges, which is why he's just got no distance control with them at all. It's called self-inflicted. Getting out of there. Oh, good save. Very good save. Should have been a birdie putt though, not a par putt. When you've got a wedge in the hand, 100 yards out, that's about where you should be putting for your birdie.